In this past week, we had Chef John Currents from Oxford, Mississippi, James Beard Award winner, and he came out with some home truths that a lot of people really didn't want to hear. When you go into a restaurant, we have this glamorous vision from food TV that it's this sort of, you know, place where people are dicing things and it's all really, you know, pretty. But what really goes into your meal is there is this unseen workforce who get there early in the morning, do the dirty work of being a line cook, being a prep cook, cleaning out the grease trap, being a night porter after everybody is gone. They're the people who are really getting your meal to the table. Mm-hmm. And if they weren't doing what they do, you wouldn't be eating in restaurants anymore.
Yes, not only how the sausage is made, it's how it's being served and then gotten rid of after you eat it, all of it or not all of it. So listen, why are these chefs so adamant about this? Probably, I would imagine, because they believe if it weren't for these people, then they probably would have a hard time keeping their doors open.
Well, the interesting thing is that he said, and Anthony Bourdain has gone on record saying this, and every chef I've ever spoken with said that the American-born workers see this glamorous version of the chef world, and they show up at a restaurant, and they want to be running the kitchen, and they're not showing up wanting to wash dishes, to, you know, schlep dirty plates, to show up early in the morning, and, you know, do all the dirty work that goes into preparing a restaurant meal. And so they're really not finding a workforce of domestic workers who want to take on these really incredibly brutal, grueling tasks. One chef I talked to said he gets these people who want to be a chef. They show up at his restaurant, they work for a while, they move to another to get experience, but they're not staying around and really learning the craft of it.
All right. That's an interesting thought. But there's another school of thought that if they paid more for these jobs, it would attract workers that are not foreign born. But look, I want to talk to you about this survey. Eatocracy is conducting a poll asking people if they knew a restaurant hired undocumented workers, would they still eat there? All right, so what do people say, Kat?
Well, the most people said, you know what, I really don't care. That, you know, it doesn't really bother them. And that actually surprised me because the debate is so hot and heavy. The next biggest group said that they don't like it, but they're willing to put up with it. You know, there was a very vocal group in the comments. We got nearly 1,100 comments on this saying that they wouldn't eat at a restaurant where they knew undocumented workers were working. But at the same time, they have to be prepared to pay more for their food, starting at the farm end where there's a whole lot of immigrant labor all the way to, to this lovely restaurant where they're getting their food. Somebody's got to pay the price. And for the most part, it's going to be the consumer, I think.
Yeah. Interesting story. Kat Kinsman, as always, thank you very much.